So I thought I would kick it off with kind of the four biggest lessons. So if I have a small amount of time with people, these are the things I try to communicate. And the first one is, which runner showed up today? Some of you guys have seen some of this stuff, right? So did you feel like this guy who's run 1 hour and 59 minutes and what was it, 40 something seconds for the marathon? Or who's this?
Eeyore.
Eeyore is very not feeling excited. He's not having a lot of pep in his step. What's interesting about the human body is some days we're more like this and some days we're more like this, right? And it's just, we're not robots. But man, those of us that are analytical, OCD, anal retentive, whatever you want to call it, we want to be robotic. We want it to be an equation. We want it to be for sure. It's not. We're a living organism. And there's so many things we can't control, right? How many of you would like to get a great night's sleep tonight? How many of you have any control over that? None of us. I have a kid. So sometimes the stress in my life is not what I planned on it being. It's different. So these things affect what runner it is that showed up. A real big key to successful athletes, whether it's new runners or Olympians, is recognizing which runner showed up today and then adjusting your training based on which runner showed up, right? So if you have a big workout, maybe it's a speed workout or a tempo run or a long run, something really important, and this guy shows up for you, what do? You take advantage of it. You like kick butt, right? This is where you post a Strava as fast as you possibly can so everybody can see the amazingness that you were on that run. What about if this guy showed up for that workout? That's unpleasant, isn't it? So you have to make decisions, right? So as coaches, we're trying to figure out, and that's why our first question is, how are you feeling? How are you feeling? How are you feeling? We're trying to get an idea of what type of runner are we dealing with for that run. Because we might make adjustments, right? If this guy shows up, I'm like, we're doing it. Go for it. Let's really kick butt today. Eeyore shows up, what am I probably going to say? Maybe we push this workout to tomorrow. You were up late, or you're stressed, or you just don't feel good. Let's see if we can push it. Oh, we can't push it to tomorrow? Well, why don't we do the lower end of what we planned, right? That makes sense. You're Eeyore today, let's do the lower end. Or, hey, let's not do as many repetitions. Or let's do the slower end of the pace range, right? Or let's forget about the pace range. Let's just run it by effort. Just do it by how you feel. Maybe we'll take it from a track workout, which is, you know, for some of us, it's really challenging when we have those numbers, and we'll just go do it as a fartlek so it's more open. Right? So this is a real key to becoming the best runner you can be, is recognizing which runner showed up and then adjusting your training. Because you need to adjust your training every day. You need to be open to adjusting your training every day based on how you feel. This is what the good athletes do. They recognize, I'm not Eliud Kipchoge today. I'm more Eeyore, so I need to adjust my expectations. And then what's the best part about adjusting your expectations?
It's easier to beat them.
Yeah, and you don't beat yourself up, right? If you're Eeyore and you're trying, you have an expectation of this guy, you're not going to be happy with that workout, right? You're going to feel like it failed or you didn't hit the goal or you ran slower than you did previously. You're going to feel bad about that. We have to protect the runner's brain. It's very fragile. So we want you always to be building positive momentum. If you feel like Eeyore, then you've got to adjust. That's a really great strategy to use. And that's what coaches are always doing. That's why they're saying, how are you feeling? And they're almost always saying, let's pull back a little bit because you're feeling a little Eeyore-like. Anybody feel Eeyore today? Some of you had long travel days and all kinds of crazy. Some of you ran marathons recently. I mean, there's lots of things, right? So I would say this is one of the most important things that I have tried to communicate to athletes over 30 years, although I should say really only 20 years, because the first 10 years I really screwed up a bunch of athletes because I wanted it to be robotic. I wanted it to be a formula. It seemed like it must be this way, right? Now I'm a little bit more open to adjustments. And that's why, at least in our system, the performances have gone way up and the injuries have gone down. I think because this can get you injured if you're Eeyore, but you're trying to run like this, right? So we try to make good adjustments. So I always encourage athletes, you know, think about it right now. When did Kipchoge show up for you guys? Has anybody had a Kipchoge run recently where you felt really good? Yeah? Oh, y'all, it's like a half? Is it a half one? A half one? When did your normal self show up? Maybe today? Maybe you felt normal? Nothing great? Nothing bad? Who's had an Eeyore run lately? Anybody had those? Lemon's had a Melody.
Every day in the summer, I'm only
now. Right. Yeah. Sweaty Eeyore, right? Yeah. I've been dealing with this. I have a back thing going on, and I don't feel good running. It feels very weird. So you have to, I just want to encourage you as you go through your training to think about this and to be open to making those adjustments. It can be very difficult if you are a really analytical person or you feel compelled that it's on the paper, I've got to get it done, just like on the paper, right? A lot of us as runners, we sort of have that compulsive nature that we like that. The more you can open yourself up to making those adjustments in your training, what you'll find is, number one, it's more positive, right? You're not setting yourself up for disappointment. So you end up coming out of runs feeling better, feeling more like, okay, I got a good run. Anybody had a good run and then the watch made you feel like it was a bad run? Anybody had that? Yeah, it's the problem with the watch, right? You do a good run and then I was so slow. But if you didn't have the watch, you would have felt great. I just had a guy, he was running, in fact, he's running this weekend or next weekend, I can't remember. Great training. But he had a run where the watch told him some numbers. His heart rate was high on a run. He's been freaking out about it. I was like, but if you didn't have your watch on, you would have thought you felt great. You're ready for the race. So it's really a mind game, isn't it? We have to be careful with this. So that's number one. Does that make sense? So can we all commit that we're going to be more open to evaluating which runner shows up and we will adjust accordingly? Use common sense. Everybody's smart enough to make those decisions objectively. We don't make them because we're emotionally tied into our running, right? We're like subjective about it. So we need to fight that. That's what the coach does, right? That's the objective part, is we're able to say, oh, well, let's just skip that or let's move that. So we do that all the time. Lemon made the Olympics. We never completed any training schedule exactly as I wrote it from the beginning. I've never had that happen. I've never had an athlete where I wrote the schedule 3, 4, 5 months out and we did the schedule. It was always massaging, right? Sick, tired, weather, snow. We lived at altitude. We got a lot of snow and we have to adjust, do this, do that. Always adjusting. That's what you're doing. So that's what this one means. Make sense?